it's a system that ties TPRS and CI down into a doable, you do this and you do this and you do this and you do this. We haven't had this in CI. Some of you may be thinking, does this take away my creativity in class? Hell no, it builds your creativity because you always know where you are safely. So Karin, thank you. And just, can I ask you what's going through your mind right now? You're gonna teach a class, you're gonna create an image, okay? So you're gonna teach a class, you're gonna create an image.
We're doing card talk.
You can use card talk. And let me show you guys an example. This is my student Bradley in India from an English home, and he was into cooking. So he drew a chef's hat. This is another guy named Jim. He likes to play basketball. Question level one, Karin. That's where you say hello, you speak English. It's a very important time to lower the affective filter in the kids. How did the cheerleading team do in that competition in Washington, D.C.? How did the basketball, how did that debate team do? You're just speaking English. Sometimes you do that for the whole period.
Hola, clase. Hi, class. Hi, class.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
How's everybody doing today?
Good.
Okay.
Fine.
Can you show me with your thumbs how you're feeling today? Excellent, class. I'm feeling great too. I'm feeling great too. Some of us are okay. That's okay. Yeah. We are going to talk today in Spanish a little bit about one of us, and it's. Oh, I have the card here. Bradley. Everybody, can we say hi to Bradley? Hi, Bradley.
Hi, Bradley.
Hey, Bradley.
Hi, Bradley. Clase. Bradley. Bradley. Bradley cocina. Bradley cocina. Bradley, cocina clase. Bradley, cocina. Bradley, cocina. Cocina. Clase. Bradley, cocina.
Sí.
Sí, sí.
Sí.
Sí, sí.
Sí.
No. Bradley, sí. Cocina.
Sí.
Sí.
Sí. Bradley, cocina.
Okay, can we stop? Because the whole idea is that it'll be harder for you, Karin, because you're on a train of thought, but. I've really been trying to figure out the most effective way to use this time we have. If I stop you here, we can talk and then answer any questions and make sure, then we can go to QL3, because you just went through two questioning levels. And the first thing I want to know, is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
Just for the purposes of the instruction.
Yeah.
Now, Does everybody, did you everybody get what the QL1 was? When I say that, that was a town meeting. It can be hello class, and then that's a town meeting. How's everybody doing? It just has to be something in English to take down their affective filter and to make sure. What I usually do is I'll pick up one or two kids every class period, and I'll say how, you know, we kind of know what's going on in their lives a little bit. Just pick a kid and say, well, how are you doing? You know, what's going on, you know? I think I asked this one kid something like, how are you doing? Or something. I was genuinely interested in. And this little kid says, I mean, like, that's weird. I've never heard a teacher ask me how I'm doing, you know? So that's the community building and questioning level one. Questions now, or then I'll go to QL2. Did you see where she went into QL2? That's who. The question is, there's always a who in all three of the way we create images. We're creating an image based on Bradley's card. Are you doing the cooking? Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
So there's this kid, and you look at this and you walk around the class, and it's the first minutes of school, and you pick one out. The reason I fold them like this is because they just put them on their desks if they have desks. They just sit there. If they don't have desks, they put them on the floor, and you walk around, and instead of reading the classroom rules and doing everything that all the other teachers are doing, which is so boring in other classes, the first thing out of your mouth is Bradley cooks. So immediately that changes their mindset a little bit. They're saying, what? Because they do like to get to know each other. They're in a class together. So this is the way you start building community. And what you'll do is, now listen carefully. She is about to go to QL3. Is everybody happy with what's happened so far? It's that simple. Mm-hmm. Did she say it too many times? No. I would say that I would like to see the Jesus rule. That means you go online, in online classes, it means you write it before you say it. Walk before you talk is the same in a regular physical classroom, but this is a basic thing about this stuff. And this is where we're going to iron out all the devils and the details things so that you guys are able to do this. And, you know, if you don't want to get coached in here and it's too nerve wracking or whatever like that, go teach your cat some language, you know, just, but do get this into your body between now and next Saturday. So you can see. Any observations on what we've seen so far? I mean, she said the same verb over and over, and yet was it boring? Not particularly. We want to know what's coming next. Back to the Jesus rule, which is really walk before you talk, just online. It's that underlining of the word before you say it. You kind of did it, but you could probably do it a little bit more. And, yeah. And is everybody tuning in on what I'm saying? Because this is all about details. That's why we're doing the class online. It's all about details. So the detail is, you need to have a little voice that says, did I, you know, that little teaching voice in the back of your head, it says, did I point to it? Did I point to the visual aid, which is the underlined word? Did I point to it before I said it? It's a massively big deal. I don't think the CI community has even picked up on the importance of doing this, but it has to do with the way the brain works, you know?
And you can't be so nervous that you go too fast. The slow here is very important.
Yeah, and she's got that down. But I think what you're trying to do is program the neurology so that they are looking at something before they hear it.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the key to the skills. I know it sounds crazy, but you know how back in the old day, back in the workshops, TPRS and all that, people would, well, you got to do this, you got to do this, and you got to do this, and you got to, now go do it. I can't keep all that in my mind. But if I'm teaching the way Karin is, her pacing is perfect. But let me see some of that where you know how, remember how Jesus does it, right?
Yeah.
It's just exactly the same. He's not afraid to hang out with that marker and underline that sucker before he opens his mouth. Okay, so I'm assuming you're gonna move on to QL3 in a second. We have a question from Hillary.
Mm-hmm. Just quick question. So the idea of not saying anything till you've walked over to the thing or you've underlined the word, there's like neurological reasons for that, that works better, you learn better if that happens?
I'm not a researcher, but I can tell you that it works for me.
Okay.
And the reason I embraced it was because I didn't feel like I had the mental brain power to learn all that the TPRS was making us learn. All of that stuff was like, there's this way to do it, and Jason Fritz is really good at it, and Blaine Ray's really good at it. Well, I'm not good at it. I can't do that. Those people are really gifted. So I needed a system that tied me down. And I always felt that since 93, roughly, depends on the research, 93% of the human experience is visual, okay? And then what you're doing is you're trying to speak a language to them where 93% of them, this is only one of the reasons I could go off on this, but I'm not. But just to say, Hillary, that if you're 93% visual and your teacher is writing something down on the board, you got to get that part out of your system before you hear it. Because what the teacher is, I'm teaching you a language and it goes in through here. And I studied the brain, and the brain has all the auditory stuff just all packed on the inside of the ears. That's where it all happens, just inside here, you know? Well, and that visual cortex is back there and it's going like, dude, I'm in charge. I'm in charge. I don't know what book this is in, but I highly recommend you do it. I can send something out. If you go online, sorry, Karin, I know this has probably got make you crazy because I wouldn't want to be interrupted either, because it's, once you get going, and by the way, you're going to be able to do this for up to 10 or 15 minutes very soon. All of you, you're going to be surprised. What I was going to say was the visual cortex back here, which runs the show in this particular society. You know, humanity has created a time in history when everything is done through screens, TV sets, everything like this. So if you let the visual, this is just my, I could see some people in the CI world that going like, what the hell are you talking about? You know, but I'm just saying what works for me is in the back of the brain where the visual cortex is, you throw it a bone. You know, you say, okay, you got to look at the word now. Now you're going to hear it. And your brain is going to do some serious calculating at that point. What it's going to do is say, that doesn't look like English. And what's going to happen is your brain is going to be allowed to do its own reorganization in terms of aperture and muscular, everything that happens here is going to happen by your deeper mind, which is, this is Krashen's contribution, you know, it's like it's all unconscious. So you can't go, and you can, if you ever find yourself going, cocina, no, say it like this, no, you gotta say it like me, cocina, that's like, it sounds like that. Those kids are going to go like, this is not meeting my needs, you know. They will, you let their brains do the work. You let their brains do all the work of recalculating.